Merhaba arkadaşlar. Welcome to the fourth recitation of the principle of macroeconomics. So in this problem set we are dealing with some balance of payments questions. So let's start with the first question. In the first question we can see two functions. They are about imports and exports and they are implicit functions. So there are some variables affecting them. And the question wants us to examine these variables and how they affect import and exports. So let's look at our first variable, it's Y, and Y stands for income. And let's assume that what happens when your income increases, you will demand more foreign products and more domestic products as well. But since we are looking at the imports, we can say that your demand on foreign products will increase since your income increases. So as seen on the answer, if income increases, consumption and demand increases, so import increases. So there is a positive relation with imports and income. So let's look at the second variable. It's PD and it stands for domestic price level. So what happens when your domestic price level increases? The foreign goods will relatively cheaper according to the domestic goods. So you will demand more foreign goods. And what happens if you demand more foreign goods? Your imports will increase. So there is a positive relationship with imports and domestic price level. So look at the PF. And what happens? PF increases and PF stands for foreign price level. If foreign price level increases, the foreign goods will be relatively expensive according to the domestic goods. So you will demand more domestic goods and less foreign goods. So imports will increase. And there is a negative relationship with imports and the foreign price level. And let's look at the exchange rate. If your domestic currency appreciates, you can demand more imports. You can demand more foreign goods because the foreign goods will become relatively cheaper since your exchange rate has appreciated. So there is a positive relationship. And let's look at the tariffs. When tariffs increases, both domestic goods and the foreign goods, both importing and exporting will be more expensive. So if tariffs increases, the imports and exports will decrease. And let's look at the YF. YF stands for foreign income. And let's assume that you are a citizen living in Germany and your income increases, you will demand more imports. You will demand, let's say that you will demand Turkish goods, more Turkish goods because your income has increased. So you will demand more imports. If you look at our country, if you look at us from the our country, our export will increase when the foreign income increases. So there is a positive relationship between foreign income and exports. So and we already explained price level of domestic goods, price of foreign goods, exchange rate and tariffs. So yeah, that was the first question. Explaining in this way is enough for answering this question. Let's move on with the second question. The second question wants us to categorize some transactions between countries. So let's look at these transactions. A Turkish citizen buying his favorite band's album, Ashbury, from abroad. So it's an import, and imports are categorized in current account. And it's in trading goods. So that was the first question. Second question says that a German bank buys shares from Borsa Istanbul in amount of 100 million Turkish liras. So it's a portfolio investment, and since it's some portfolio investment, it's in financial account. It's not a direct investment because the bank buys shares. They are not directly investing something. So it's some portfolio investment. And let's look at the C. A service provider in Turkey creates a website for a foreign customer. So it's an export and it's a service. So it's a trading service. It's not a good. And since it's a trading service and it's an export, We categorize this transaction in current account. So let's move on with D. An Italian car manufacturer, and let's say that it's Fiat, decided to open a new factory in Turkey. So they are making a direct investment in Turkey. So it's a direct investment. And we can categorize it in financial account. Let's move on with E. A Turkish citizen decided to invest in SAP, S&P 500 shares. So it's a portfolio investment and it's in financial account. Let's look at F. After calculating the capital account, financial account, current account and change in reserve assets, we found out that there exists some amount of error. So we categorize errors in the net errors balance. So answer is net errors, because you know that after calculating the capital account, financial account, current account and change in reserve assets, it must be equal to zero. If it's not equal to zero, there must be some errors. So we categorize this error in the net errors balance. So let's move on with G. A British citizen buying her favorite band's album, Çilekeş. So some foreign citizen demanding our product. So it's an export for us. And export, we can categorize export in trading goods. And trading goods, we can categorize it in current account. It's in current account because it's import and exports are current account balance. Let's move on with H. A Turkish video game company created a game called, let's say, the Bannerlord, and they sold 1 million copies in United States. So it's an export as well, and it's a good, it's trading goods, so it's in current accounts. And let's move on with I. A foreign company bought 40% of shares of a Turkish company. Since it's they are buying 40% of the shares, and it's higher than the 10%, it's not a portfolio investment, but it's a direct investment. And since it's a direct investment, it's in the financial account balance. So that was the second question. Let's move on with the third question. And in the third question, we can see the financial account of Turkey between the years 1975 and 2019. And we can see that there are some peaks and troughs. The question wants us to examine the truths in this question. And we can observe two truths, actually. The first one starts in 2001. And there is a true in here. And the second one starts in 2009 and the end of the 2008. So it starts to decline in here. And there is a true in here. So we should examine this. This graph, what tells this? Sorry, there was a problem with my computer, so I think I resumed the recording. So let's continue. This graph tells us that there are some huge restriction. I mean, foreigners retreat their investment, financial investment to their own country. So let's say that a foreign investor bought a lot of shares in Turkey, and after the 2001 they sold their shares in Turkey and they get their money back. So when they do that, we can see negative financial account balance. So what might be the reason of this truth? The reasons might be 2001 crisis. There was a financial crisis in 2001. So when there are some crises that are not stability, the foreign investors get their money back from the foreign country and they don't invest anymore. So there are huge financial account restriction in 2001 until the 2005-2007. And the same thing happens in the end of the 2008 and beginning of the 2009. There were A financial crisis and the foreign investors get their money back until the 2013, so we can say at ruin here. And we can say that after the 2013, the foreign investors starting to invest in Turkey again. So we are increasing in the financial account balance in terms of financial account. So yeah, that was the answer of this question. We can say that the reason of this truce are 2001 crisis and the 2008 crisis. So let's move on with the fourth question. We can see that the statistical dependency data is missing, and the question says that you should find the statistical dependency according to this table. In the first part, you should what should you think? You should do categorize current account and the financial account, and after you sum up them, it should be zero. If it's not zero, there must be a statistical dependency, and your finding must be equal to the statistical dependency. So let's categorize the current account. We have wrote the exports, we have wrote the imports, and when we sum of them, when we sum them, it's equal to this number. We do the same thing for the services, and the balance of services is this number. And there are some income received on investments and income payments on investments. They are included in the current account as well. And we make the net balance of current account, and it's equal to this number. And we move on with the financial account. We calculate the financial account balance, increase in foreign holdings of assets in the United States, plus increase in US holdings of assets in foreign countries. We get this number. And if you calculate minus 138 plus 82, we will end up with, oops, minus 86. So what's the idea in here? Current account balance plus financial account balance plus statistical dependency must be equal to zero. So this part is equal to minus 56 plus SD. So a statistical dependency must be equal to 56. So this is our answer. This is written in here. So let's move on with the multiple choice questions. Let's get the first question. Which of the following is not part of the balance of payments? Capital account is a part of balance of payments. Financial account is a part of balance of payments. Current account is a part of balance of payments. Net errors is a part of balance of payments, and change in reserves is a part of balance of payments, but net trade account is not a part of balance of payments. So let's move on with the second question. The question says that we are in a capital account, blah blah blah, when more capital flows into the country. What happens if there is more capital flows into the country than flows out of the country? So we must have a surplus because there are more coming than the outgoing. So we might have a surplus, not a deficit, not a leakage, or not stability. The stability is unrelated in this question. So the answer is surplus. So let's move on with the third question. A current account deficit means that as a country, we import more than we export. Because the current account deficit means that since it's a deficit, the imports must be higher than exports. It means that deficit. But what happens if our exports is higher than our imports? It means that there is a surplus. And let's advance this question a little bit further. And let's say that there are no financial transactions in a country. There are no financial account. There is only current account balance and change in reserve assets. So what happens if your imports are higher than exports and you have suffering from a deficit? It means that your change in reserves must be equal to the negative number. It means that when you are suffering from deficit, you should pay your debts from your own reserve. So the change in reserves must be equal to the negative number. In the other hand, when your exports are higher than imports, it means that you are experiencing a surplus on the current account. So there are more money coming from abroad than there are outgoing money. So the change in reserve assets must be equal to a positive number. So the answer is imports and exports. And let's move on with the fourth question. Which one of the following is a something a country can do with the dollars they get from selling products to the United States? So let's say that you're a exporting firm and you export your goods to the United States, and as a return you get some United States dollars, US dollars. So what can you do with US dollars? You can buy US treasury bills, yes. You can invest in US companies, yes, with US dollars you can invest in them. You can buy US goods and services, yes. If you want to buy US goods and services, you need to pay them with US dollars. And since you export some goods, you have some US dollars, it means that you can do all of them. So the answer is D. And let's move on with the fifth question. Which one of the below is not included in the direct investment? So what is the direct investment? Direct investment means that you either open a factory, open a new service, or open some office in the country that produces something, or you need to buy higher than 10% of the shares of the domestic country. So let's look at the answers. A foreign company opens a new factory in the domestic country that can produce up to a lot of bottles of beverages per day. So it's included in direct investment. A foreign investment by 28% of the shares of a domestic country, it's included in the direct investment because it's higher than the 10%. And D says that a video game company called Rito opens an office and installs new hosting services for their video game in the domestic country. So it's an direct investment. They opened an office. You can think that they opened a factory. So it's included in the direct investment. But in the B, it says that a foreign investor buys 4% of the shares of a domestic country. And since it's less than 10%, it's not included in the direct investment, but it's included in the portfolio investment. So why we are talking about the 10% shares? When you buy more than 10% shares of a country, you will be able to talk in the administration of this country. You can control this you can control that firm. So it will be a direct investment. But if you buy less than 10% of the shares, you will not have right. You won't have a right of talking in the administration of this firm, so it will be just basically a portfolio investment. So let's move on with the sixth question. Current account plus capital account plus financial account plus net errors and omissions plus change in reserves must be equal to, we know that in our lectures, it must be equal to the zero. The balance must be equal to the zero. It's not a positive number, not a negative number. It must be equal to the zero. Let's move on with the seventh question. So there is a graph you should examine in this question for the following two questions. and let's examine what happens in 2012. In 2012, it's in here. So there are high foreign investors in the country. So the net portfolio is negative. And it means that the foreign investments in our domestic country is higher than our investment to the foreign countries. So the answer should be foreign residents portfolio investment in Turkey is more than the Turkish residents portfolio investment in abroad. That's the true answer. The foreign residents portfolio investments are higher in 2012. So in this eighth question, it says that what happens in 2008? So let's look at the 2008. So we can see that our investments in abroad in the foreign countries are higher than the foreign investments in our country. So the net portfolio is positive. And it means that Turkish residents portfolio investment in abroad is more than the foreign residents portfolio investment in Turkey. So the true answer is B. And let's move on with the ninth question. Which transaction will not increase supply of foreign exchange? So what increases your supply of foreign exchange? The basically exports can increase your supply of foreign exchange. So when you export some goods, in return you get US dollars or some euros or foreign currency. So let's look at the answers. Textile company exporting some goods. It will increase foreign exchange. Supply of foreign exchange. A web designer designs a foreign website for some money. So it's an export again. It's a service export. So it will increase supply of foreign exchange as well. C says that a foreign investment bank purchases $1 million amount of domestic shares. So let's say that the German bank buys some shares from the Borsa İstanbul. So it means that there are some money coming from abroad. The foreign currency coming into the Turkey, so it will increase supply of foreign exchange. But a domestic investment is investor buys some value of foreign country bonds. Actually, it decreases the foreign exchange supply of foreign exchange. So the third answer is D. Let's move on with the next question. Which event is likely to appreciate Turkish lira? So what we learn in our lectures, in the short run, if you have high interest rate, then your domestic currency should be appreciate. And let's look at the answers. Central bank supplying a lot of money of Turkish liras. So when the money supply increases, it's not related with the exchange rate. Yeah, in advanced economic classes, you can see some models about when the money supply increases, the interest rate will decrease. When the interest rate will decrease, the exchange rate will depreciate. So the B is not the true answer. Currency traders expect the Turkish lira to depreciate. When some people expect to Turkish lira to depreciate, it will depreciate. So C is false. And indeed, central bank declares an expansion monetary policy. Expansionary means that they are printing new money to the market. So it's the same idea with this answer. Money supply will increase, interest rate will fall, and the exchange will depreciate. So D is not a true answer. The true answer is a foreign investor attracted by high interest rate on Turkish bond buys some amount of bonds. So what happens? What is the logic in here? You are a foreign investor, let's say, and you have some money, and you are looking for some investments, and you look at the Turkish bonds. You can see that their interest rate is relatively higher than the other countries. Let's say that Turkish bonds give you 8% of interest rate, and let's say that US bond gives you 6% of interest rate. What will you choose? You will choose Turkish bonds because their return is higher than the US bonds. So you get your US dollars and come to the Turkey. You convert your US dollars to the Turkish liras and buy Turkish bonds. So what happened in here? In the Turkey, supply of foreign exchange increased. And what happens if supply of foreign exchange increases? Your domestic currency appreciates in the short run. So the true answer is A. The last question is similar to the previous question. Which event is likely to appreciate Turkish lira in the long run? So we are not talking about interest rate or anything. We are talking about in the long run in this question. So increasing interest rate implying contraction monetary policy is not helpful in the long run. Increasing private savings is not helpful in the long run. Attaining an unsustainable balance of payments, which is fragile to external shocks, is a very bad thing for the exchange rate for your currency. So it's not the answer. The answer is attracting higher education level. So what happens when your education level is getting higher?